the 1988 Miss Mississippi Troupe, the Jimmy Mullins Orchestra, Miss Mississippi Dancers, and 40 young women vying for the crown, Miss Mississippi 1989. Mississippi Pageant is brought to you in part by Chitney Jungle, where we do everything special, especially for you.
I tell you, you keep it up. These girls, they've worked hard all week long, and they enjoy your encouragement, so thank you a lot.
You know, it's going to be a very exciting night, teaching the talent, accomplishment, and hard work of our state's most outstanding young women. And we're glad that all of you are here. Through our live telecast, we're here to share these exciting final hours of competition. From the beautiful Municipal Auditorium, we're here tonight where our new Miss Mississippi will be crowned.
That's right, Matt. You know, I remember when I was crowned Miss Tennessee, I just knew that night was going to be the start of something big. In my case, big turned out to be Nashville, and for our next Miss Mississippi, two things are certain. She'll be on her way to Atlantic City in September, and she will never be the same again. One young woman on this stage will assume a historic title that will follow her throughout life, Miss Mississippi 1989. Will it be?
Good evening. I am Missy Hurdle, Miss Rankin County, a junior at the University of Mississippi.
Tracy Yarborough ID. I'm currently a sophomore at Northwest Community.
Mississippi College, where I'm presently a senior.
Gentlemen, your 1989 contestants. One year ago tonight, a dream came true for a young lady from Hattiesburg. She won the hearts of the judges with a fabulous voice and song. In September, she represented our state in Atlantic City, winning a swimsuit preliminary award and placing as a top 10 finalist. We've been very proud of her. She's been a great representative of Mississippi. Please greet Miss Mississippi 1988, Carla Haig.
In a few moments, the field of 40 contestants will be narrowed down to 10 finalists who will continue in competition for the title of Miss Mississippi 1989 and the honor of representing our great state in the Miss America pageant. So stay tuned. We'll be right back. Our contestants have come to the pageant tonight from every area of Mississippi. And Dittany hopes that you're enjoying the pageant that features the best. Dittany is featuring the best of our state as well this week. Mississippi products like those from Uncle Ben's. Dittany brings you Uncle Ben's pasta salad for only $1.49, a super buy on a dish that really livens up summer meals. Uncle Ben's among the fine Mississippi products at Dittany, where we do everything special, especially for you.
As Vicksburg's mayor and alderman, we'd like to take a moment and share our city with you. From the busiest river port in Mississippi to Vicksburg's many retail shops, you'll find a friendly, thriving, progressive city. While striving to keep Vicksburg on the move, we always remind her of our city's rich history. We invite you to come to Vicksburg, revel in our past, and share our hopes for the future. You'll have an unforgettable experience.
Dive in the summer splash sale at the Sleep Shop. This cherry bedroom group is Sleep Shop price starting at only $18.99 complete. The Rosette water bed only $3.99. The Blazer bed is Sleep Shop priced at just $2.49. The Newport Rose only $4.49. The Baja Rose just $3.99. And the West Wind is just $4.49 at the Sleep Shop. Get free layaway or 6 months interest-free financing during the summer splash sale. Dive in the savings at the Sleep Shop. Bar 50 Drive, Tupelo, and Highway 72 East in Corinth.
Shop the inventory liquidation sale at Carpet City and save up to 50% off all carpet and vinyl in stock. Nylon cut and loop, $4.99 a square yard. Level loop carpet, $2.99 a square yard. Lee Stainmaster carpet is just $8.99 a square yard. Stain release trackless carpet, $6.99 a square yard. 15-foot wide carpet, $5.99 a square yard. No wax vinyl starting at $2.99 a square yard. Don't miss Carpet City's inventory liquidation sale. No interest and no payment for 90 days. Just 2 blocks south of JCPenney in Tupelo.
Welcome back. The awesome responsibility of selecting Miss Mississippi falls upon a very accomplished group of individuals. My pleasure to introduce at this time our distinguished panel of five judges. To be sure, two of Atlantic City's most celebrated events, the Miss Atlantic City Pageant and the Miss America Breakfast, Director of Public Relations and Special Events for that city, hosted numerous talk shows and television specials. Please welcome Sandra Usry Hollingsworth. Our second judge is the past president of a 30-year associate of the Miss Georgia Pageant. He has judged over 300 Miss America state and local preliminaries. Please welcome Mr. Joe Dickens. Soon to start his second decade as executive director of the Miss Alabama Pageant. Our next judge has accompanied 6 Miss America Pageant finalists to Atlantic City, devoted business manager, public relations coordinator, and traveling companion for that state. Give a giant Mississippi welcome to Nora Chapman. Former member of the Miss Louisiana Pageant Board of Directors, judge of numerous state and local Miss America preliminary pageants, he has been JC of the Year and Outstanding Young Man of America. Please welcome Mr. Randy Harrison. Our final judge comes to us all the way from Pennsylvania, former producer of the Miss Delaware Pageant, and now a member of the Miss Pennsylvania Contestant Preparation and Production Staff. Veteran pageant judge, please greet Aura M. Hill. Ladies and gentlemen, our 1989 Miss Mississippi judges, thank you all very much for being with us this week. Our auditors tonight are Donna Ingram, CPA, and James Billingsley. Thank you very much. During preliminary competitions, each of our contestants competed in talent, evening gown, and swimsuit, and each was interviewed personally by our judges and scored individually. The moment has arrived when we will find out which of our 10 Miss Mississippi contestants have received the highest cumulative scores during this week's competition. Ladies and gentlemen, the 10 finalists in no particular order. Here they are, our first finalist, Miss Tupelo, Cherry Busby. Our second finalist, Miss Hattiesburg, Kathy Partman.
Our next finalist is Miss Dixieland, Dana Dalton. Please join her on stage, Miss Natchez Trace, Darby Pope.
We'll be halfway towards our top 10 with Miss Dixie, Becky Blouin. Come on down, Miss Rankin County, Misty Hammock.
Our next finalist is Miss Gulf Coast, Nicole Bethmann. Joining her, we have Miss Morton, Shelly Traxler.
our ninth finalist, Miss Clinton, Angie Gilstrap. And our final contestant with an opportunity to become Miss Mississippi, Miss Magnolia Missy Hurdle. Begin a brand new competition. The only points carried over from preliminaries are from contestant interviews with the judges. Those points will be added to tonight's scores in swimsuit, talent, and evening gown. Remember that talent counts for 40% of all the total score, with interview counting 30% and swimsuit and evening gown each counting 15%. Now when we come back, we'll introduce you to several former Miss Mississippi. Jungle is proud to be a sponsor of the Miss Mississippi Pageant this evening, and Dittany is proud to bring you the greatest values on fine Mississippi products, including delicious meats from Brian Foods, the flavor of the South. Brian has been making the South's favorite products for over 50 years. At Dittany, you'll find versatile Brian Vienna sausage at 3 cans for only $1. Brian Foods, a special value this week at Dittany, where we do everything special, especially for you.
The Port of Vicksburg handles a vast product inventory that includes lumber, cotton, steel, and paper. The facility is the busiest river port in Mississippi due to its innovative loading methods, a comprehensive inventory system, and its status as a foreign trade zone. In merging the Old South with the New South, the Warren County Port Commission has purchased the historic Ceres Plantation on I-20 East to create a 1,000-acre industrial park scheduled for operation in 1990. The heritage of the site will be carefully preserved. When it comes to economic progress, Vicksburg and Warren County are totally committed.
The young women competing for the crown tonight are among Mississippi's greatest assets. They set good examples and they bring wide attention to the quality of life in our state. We at the People's Bank are proud to live and work in many of the communities represented here. And we share the obvious pride in families, schools, and their hometowns. To each of the young ladies from our part of the world, we wish you the best of luck.
Little Bits Specialty Shop has moved from the country to the city. Little Bits is now open in their all-new and modern location in the Willow Bend Village, 142 South Industrial Road, Tupelo. Whether your plans have you at the barn with your favorite horse, taking a cruise in your convertible, shooting pool, or taking a plunge in the pool, Little Bits offers high-quality clothing for the petite lady at moderate prices. Open Monday through Saturday, 10 a.m. to 6 p.m., Little Bits, Willow Bend Village, Tupelo.
Mississippi has been represented in the Miss America pageant almost since the beginning. That means we have a lot of history and heritage to be proud of as a pageant. Mississippi claims 4 Miss Americas and many finalists, and we are pleased to have in our audience some Miss Mississippi of former years. I've asked them to join us on stage. May I present Betty Jane Porter Hallberg, Miss Mississippi 1969. Mississippi 1980. Karen Hobson Moen, Miss Mississippi 1981. Mississippi 1982. Mississippi 1986. Thank you to all of our former Miss Mississippis with us tonight. We're also pleased to have some visiting queens with us from other states. I have to guess Stacy King, Miss Louisiana, 1989. The past year has been special for four of our 1988 contestants, when they were selected to appear throughout the state as members of the Miss Mississippi troupe. They've been received with great enthusiasm, and we want you to meet them now. Ladies? Teresa Coughlin, Miss Greenville, 1988, Michelle Rowell, Miss Gulf Coast, 1988, and Renee Dunn, Miss Madison County, 1988. How about another round of applause? Thank you, ladies. We'll be right back in just a moment as the 1989 Miss Mississippi Pageant continues with swimsuit competition and clips from our top 10 finalists.
contestants in the pageant have worked hard this week preparing for this special night. Jitney's worked hard, too, on a very special sale on products made here in Mississippi, like creamy, delicious Lady Borden ice cream made with the finest ingredients. Jitney has a free half gallon of Lady Borden ice cream for you when you buy one at the regular price. All your favorite flavors, too. Lady Borden ice cream, a great Mississippi product at Jitney, where we do everything special, especially for you.
In all walks of life, things tend to come and go, like some financial institutions who don't quite have their feet on the ground. But at NBC, we don't follow another's footsteps because we've known exactly where we're going for over 100 years, while always taking steps to provide the right banking services for a world on the move. So come to the bank that's sturdy enough to weather 100 years and flexible enough to take you through the next 100. NBC, the bank that's just right.
Mississippians have a special spirit all their own, a sense of pride, accomplishment, and genuine concern for their neighbors that shows in the way they live every day. Hear their stories as we introduce you to one of these special people every Thursday night on WTVA News. And if you know of someone who should be honored, write us at WTVA, P.O. Box 350, Tupelo, Mississippi 38802, as we continue to find and recognize the people who live the spirit of Mississippi.
Here in the Vicksburg Auditorium, where tonight's first phase of competition is swimsuit, here the judges look for beauty, confidence, fitness, and overall poise. We will also have an opportunity to see a brief segment from the personal interviews our top 10 finalists had with the panel of judges earlier in the week. Contestant number 13, Miss Tupelo, Cherry Busby. She was asked, "Why do you want to be Miss Mississippi?" Here's what she said.
Stand up for something in Mississippi as well as in America. There needs to be somebody who will hold up some type of standard, and I believe that I could do that.
Contestant number 10, Miss Hattiesburg, Kathy Parkman. She was asked, "What does Miss America program offer a young woman?" This is how she responded.
Two weeks ago. Also, the Miss America program offers, I think, being a lady.
Number 40, Miss Dixieland Dana Dalton was asked, "What would you tell a first-timer to the state pageant?" Her answer was this.
Many first-timers I've told, go and just want to do your very best, because there's so much that you won't be expecting to happen when you get there. There are so many girls that are so good. You were the best in your pageant. But all these other girls were the best in their pageant, too. Just remember that.
Hope, Miss Natchez Trace, was asked, "In light of scandal, have TV evangelists helped or hindered religion?" This is what she said.
That they have done both. It depends on the person and what they really, if they really are there for religious purposes or just for the money.
Blouin was asked, on what issue would you speak out as Miss Mississippi? Here's her response.
I'd say equal opportunity, having careers, having families. I think that's very important. But beyond women's, I think the major issue, the major platform I would take would just be to save our planet Earth. And I think as a woman, I can do that too, because that's very important. Sometimes we look at beyond these issues and we forget about the planet Earth and how important it is.
Contestant number one, Miss Rankin County, Missy Hammock, was asked in an interview, does the press delve too deeply into celebrities' personal lives? This is what she said.
I definitely think so. I think that there is a certain limit to how far they can delve into that. And I think that, you know, there are times when I think they do go too deep, and I think there should be a stopping point for some of it, yes.
Number 34, Nicole Bethmann, Miss Gulf Coast, was asked, how do you feel about 18-year-olds being allowed to serve alcohol but not be able to buy it? Here's what she said.
I feel that they shouldn't even be able to serve whiskey. I think it's too much of a temptation today. And I think that's what's wrong with most of our youth in society. There are too many temptations through media, through magazines, through TV, radio, songs. I think there's just too much temptation. If we could tempt them with better things such as religious activities or more school activities or college activities, they'd be better off.
Shelley Draxler was asked, should the Miss America pageant eliminate the swimsuit competition? Her response?
No, I think swimsuit competition is a very important competition for the Miss America program. Miss America herself needs to be in good physical condition. And I think swimsuit is the best way to tell that.
Contestant number six, Miss Clinton Angie Gilstrap, was asked, describe your management style as a personal manager. This is her reply.
Meetings and keeping them up with what I feel, how I feel a business should be run, like a tight ship, and communication.
Contestant number 29, Missy Hurdle, Miss Magnolia. She's asked, are you a Southern Belle? Here's her response.
I think that maybe you could classify me that in a positive way. I think I'm Southern, and then I live in the South, and I think Southern girls tend to have something. Well, sociologists have proven this in studies that I've read about, that they have a little edge. They really believe in tradition, and if that's what you want to classify Southern Belle as, I think I'm one.
top 10 finalists in swim suits. Stay tuned for more of the 1989 Miss Mississippi Pageant. We'll be right back. This year's pageant's exciting, isn't it? Sydney has some shopping excitement for you this week, too, and our salute to the finest products made here in Mississippi. This week at Vintney, you can save on a traditional favorite, Marshall Durbin Hole Fryers. These USDA-inspected fryers are packed 2 to a bag and only 59 cents a pound at Vintney. Marshall Durbin Hole Fryers, a quality Mississippi product at Vintney, where we do everything special, especially for you.
The Miss Mississippi Pageant is now offering its annual program book for sale by mail. The 500-page book for 1989 includes a pictorial salute to the 40 contestants, plus former Miss Mississippi winners, Miss Americas from our state, and much, much more. Each program book is just $10 plus $2.95 each for shipping and handling. To order, send your name and address along with a check or money order to Miss Mississippi Pageant, P.O. Box 742, Vicksburg, Mississippi 39180, or phone 638-6746.
The young women competing for the crown tonight are among Mississippi's greatest assets. They set good examples and they bring wide attention to the quality of life in our state. We at the People's Bank are proud to live and work in many of the communities represented here. And we share their obvious pride in families, schools, and their hometowns. To each of the young ladies from our part of the world, we wish you the best of luck.
Is working to raise cash to help the sick kids at Lavana. Drink to their health.
Matt Davenport. What a nice number. Wasn't that great? It makes contestants look beautiful. All 40 contestants are very, very talented. In fact, talent competition has always been an exciting and unique aspect of the Miss America program. One face that really sets it apart from other pageants. Now for your entertainment and the judges' consideration, we begin with the first contestant. The Lady Sings the Blues is the story of Billie Holiday's life. Our first contestant will sing Stormy Weather, a popular blues number from this classic. Please welcome Jerry Busby, Miss Tupelo. Special thanks on behalf of the Miss Mississippi pageant to Barry Snyder and Showmax Originals for the beautiful gowns they have provided for our principals tonight. Thank you very much. Our next contestant will sing Four Wondering Ones from Pirates of Penzance. Here's Kathy Portman with Hattiesburg. Oh,
will be a week to remember. Jitney hopes you're enjoying the glamour and excitement of this special night. And we hope you enjoy the special values of Mississippi products this week at your neighborhood Jitney, like delicious flavor-rich homogenized milk. A gallon of flavor-rich milk is only $1.99 at Jitney, and it's fresh to you from right here in Mississippi. Look for all the fine flavor-rich family of products at your neighborhood Jitney, where we do everything special, especially for you.
The Port of Vicksburg handles a vast product inventory that includes lumber, cotton, steel, and paper. The facility is the busiest river port in Mississippi due to its innovative loading methods, a comprehensive inventory system, and its status as a foreign trade zone. In merging the Old South with the New South, the Warren County Port Commission has purchased the historic Ceres Plantation on I-20 East to create a 1,000-acre industrial park scheduled for operation in 1990. The heritage of the site will be carefully preserved. When it comes to economic progress, Vicksburg and Warren County are totally committed.
Since 1925, when Tom Houston first sold Tom's Toasted Peanuts from his truck, generation after generation has grown up with that great Tom's taste. The taste that is just as good and fresh today as that very first time you enjoyed it as a kid. And just as you've grown up, so has Tom's. We're not just peanuts. We have a variety of snack foods perfect for all occasions. And we guarantee the quality and taste of our products. Tom's, enjoy it again. It's like finding an old friend.
Yellow 30 minutes from now, my reputation goes on the line. Coming through. They're second to best. That's why these steaks are from Jitney. All the beef at Jitney is USDA sourced. Trimmed just right, of course. And I can always count on tenderness.
Great steak, friend.
It's especially for you.
You got it. Great steak at your neighborhood Jitney, where we do everything special, especially for you.
Losing a love can shatter your dreams and kill all hope of loving again. Here to portray this torment, and I dreamed a dream, is Dana Dalton of Dixieland.
Love would never know.
From Broadway with Barbara Streisand to the Grand Ole Opry with Patsy Cline, presenting an original medley of Can't Help Loving That Man and Crazy is Darby Pope with Natchez Trace.
Special thanks to the Vicksburg JT, sponsors of the Miss Mississippi Scholarship Pageant. Thank you very much. And we'll be back with more talent after this important message.
The Miss Mississippi Pageant is the perfect showcase for our state's beauty and talent. And right now, Mississippi's largest retailer, Jitney Jungle, is showcasing the finest products made here in Mississippi. Products like Coca-Cola, first bottled here in Mississippi, and now a favorite here and everywhere. Enjoy the entire family of Coca-Cola products at a savings when you shop Jitney. Coca-Cola, featured now at your neighborhood Jitney, where we do everything special, especially for you.
As Vicksburg's mayor and alderman, we'd like to take a moment and share our city with you. From the busiest river port in Mississippi to Vicksburg's many retail shops, you'll find a friendly, thriving, progressive city.
While striving to keep Vicksburg on the move, we always remind her of our city's rich history.
We invite you to come to Vicksburg, revel in our past, and share our hopes for the future. You'll have an unforgettable experience.
The Miss Mississippi Pageant is now offering its annual program book for sale by mail. The 500-page book for 1989 includes a pictorial salute to the 40 contestants, plus former Miss Mississippi winners, Miss Americas from our state, and much, much more. Each program book is just $10 plus $2.95 each for shipping and handling. To order, send your name and address along with a check or money order to Miss Mississippi Pageant, P.O. Box 742, Vicksburg, Mississippi 39180, or phone 638-6746.
30 minutes from now, my reputation goes on the line. Coming through. They're second to best. That's why these steaks are from Jitney. All the beef at Jitney is USDA choice. Seems just right, of course. And I can always count on tenderness.
Great steak, friend.
It's especially for you.
We got it. Great steak at your neighborhood Jitney, where we do everything special, especially for you.
Sweetheart, we really need to fix up the yard.
Okay, so how's this?
What?
This.
But I...
Ooh, and look, would this be nice?
But how did...
And try this out.
How did you do that?
Oh, I had a little hope. You know, there's still something missing.
I know.
No, I know what's missing.
Loans and lines of credit from Deposit Guarantee.
WTVA presents a special comedy lineup this Sunday afternoon. Laugh with B. Arthur, Rue McClanahan, Betty White, and Estelle Getty, the Golden Girls at noon. Then at 12:30, join Carol, Barbara, and Laverne as Richard Mulligan stars in Empty Net. That's a special comedy lineup this Sunday afternoon on WTVA, the Spirit of Mississippi.
Contestant combines the artistic disciplines of classical ballet and singing. Presenting an aria from BJ's opera Carmen is Becky Blouin, Miss Gypsy.
Thank you.
In 1964, Broadway brought us the musical Funny Girl, a portrayal of the life of Fanny Bryce. Here singing the ragtime melody Cornet Man that gave Fanny her big break is Missy Hammock, Miss Rankin County.
I just took a kiss of me and swept it back. Big my sweet man sat around and watched him pass. On a moment's notice, Jason gates with Billy Bates and ragtime Otis. The lady ain't seen like can give the horn a fair fight with a cornet man, a rootin' through the never wouldn't have a plan. Who cares if it's just a part of me, never free.
Contestants will be on her way to an exciting career like so many of our previous winners. It's all part of the promise of the Miss Mississippi pageant. Sydney salutes all the pageant contestants, and we're saluting many other Mississippians too, like the folks who bring you pulse sausage, a great value right now at Jiffney, just $1.49 a pound. Save on delicious pulse sausage at Jiffney, where we do everything special, especially for you.
The Port of Vicksburg handles a vast product inventory that includes lumber, cotton, steel, and paper. The facility is the busiest river port in Mississippi due to its innovative loading methods, a comprehensive inventory system, and its status as a foreign trade zone. In merging the Old South with the New South, the Warren County Port Commission has purchased a historic series plantation on I-20 East to create a 1,000-acre industrial park scheduled for operation in 1990. The heritage of the site will be carefully preserved. When it comes to economic progress, Vicksburg and Warren County are totally committed.
The young women competing for the crown tonight are among Mississippi's greatest assets. They set good examples and they bring wide attention to the quality of life in our state. We at the People's Bank are proud to live and work in many of the communities represented here. And we share their obvious pride in families, schools, and their hometowns. To each of the young ladies from our part of the world, we wish you the best of luck. We
live in a time that demands instantaneous communication worldwide.
That makes fair, complete reporting of the news crucial every day.
The events that shape our lives can happen here at home or halfway around the world.
That's why the experienced team of NBC News and WTVA News is so important.
NBC Nightly News with Tom Brokaw at 5:30, followed by WTVA News at 6 and 10.
When North Mississippi needs to know, it turns to NBC Nightly News and WTVA News.
From country and western to the classics, our next contestant sings them all. Tonight she'll sing a patriotic medley of songs born during a period of war and strife. Here's Nicole Bethmann, with Gulf Coast. Performing a song from the Phantom of the Opera entitled Think of Me is our next contestant. Shelley Traxler, Miss Morton.
Thank you.
close to the excitement of tonight's pageant, but there are plenty of exciting savings on Mississippi products for you at Jitney. Mississippi homes have always depended on Pine Sol Cleaner and other trusted products made here in Mississippi. And right now, the 15-ounce bottle of Pine Sol is specially priced at only 99 cents at your neighborhood Jitney. It's a great time to stock up. Pine Sol, another real value at Jitney, where we do everything special, especially for you.
This annual program book for sale by mail. The 500-page book for 1989 includes a pictorial salute to the 40 contestants, plus former Miss Mississippi winners, Miss Americas from our state, and much, much more. Each program book is just $10 plus $2.95 each for shipping and handling. To order, send your name and address along with a check or money order to Miss Mississippi Pageant, P.O. Box 742, Vicksburg, Mississippi 39180, or phone 638-6746.
It's summertime and Curtis Mathis is having a sizzling summer sale. And that means some real hot deals that will save you plenty on one of these super Curtis Mathis products. Plus, to get our famous customer protection plan that covers all parts and labor for 6 years. Now you could warm up to that, couldn't you? The Curtis Mathis sizzling summer sale. Oh man, that's hot.
Okay, and Bertie, we enjoy your coming to our center so much and all the good work you do for senior citizens. We enjoy your morning show. We love the old songs, the lovely quilt, and the band is real good too. Please come back to our center soon. We all love you, Rosemary Barber.
Well, bless your heart. I'm glad that you took time out to send us a letter and card and let us know how you're feeling. Why don't you write to us again? I'm glad you watched the show.
The musical Oliver has delighted audiences for many years with its flourishing melody. Our next contestant would like to share with you her interpretation of this exciting song, Who Will Buy? Please welcome Angie Gilchrist, Miss Clinton.
Rise, rise, rise,
Our last contestant will perform for you a vocal, O'Neill Fabino from Gianni Schicchi Opera. Here is Missy Hurdle, Miss Magnolia. To Jitney Jungle, one of our statewide telecast sponsors, and to the national sponsors of the Miss America Pageant for their support of our state program through cash scholarships. They include the Gillette Company, Pillsbury Clairol Division, Classic with Pride in the USA, Councils Incorporated, Chevrolet Motor Division, Fruit of the Loom, and No Nonsense Hosiery. We'll be right back with more of the Miss Mississippi Pageant.
Pageant is a tradition that gets better every year, and Jitney's salute to Mississippi products is even more exciting this year, too. Jitney has savings on the delicious Bryan family of products made right here in Mississippi, including tasty hickory-smoked Bryan bacon, only 99 cents for a 12-ounce package at Jitney. Bryan, the flavor of the South, and the favorite for over 50 years. A great value at Jitney, where we do everything special, especially for you.
As Vicksburg's mayor and aldermen, we'd like to take a moment and share our city with you. From the busiest river port in Mississippi to Vicksburg's many retail shops, you'll find a friendly, thriving, progressive city.
While striving to keep Vicksburg on the move, we always remind her of our city's rich history.
We invite you to come to Vicksburg, revel in our past, and share our hopes for the future. You'll have an unforgettable experience.
Dive in the summer splash sale at the Sleep Shop. This cherry bedroom group is Sleep Shop price starting at only $18.99 complete. The Rosette water bed only $3.99. The Blazer bed is Sleep Shop price at just $2.49. The Newport Rose only $4.49. The Baja Rose just $3.99. And the West Wind is just $4.49 at the Sleep Shop. Get free layaway for 6 months, interest-free financing during the summer splash sale. Dive in the savings at the Sleep Shop. Varsity Drive, Tupelo, and Highway 72 East in Corinth.
The young women competing for the crown tonight are among Mississippi's greatest assets. They set good examples, and they bring wide attention to the quality of life in our state. We at the People's Bank are proud to live and work in many of the communities represented here, and we share their obvious pride in families, schools, and their hometowns. To each of the young ladies from our part of the world, we wish you the best of luck.
Gown competition allows our contestants an opportunity to show beauty, poise, and speaking ability. Shelly.
Thank you, Matt. Again this year, each contestant will have the opportunity to express her beliefs by answering an on-stage question which pertains to current issues and opinions and will be selected at random by the contestants. Evening gown competition begins with contestant number 13.
Jerry Busby, Miss Tupelo. Jerry, what impact has this week of pageantry had on your life?
I think this week of pageantry has made me a much more outgoing person and made me a lot more comfortable in front of a lot of people and when handling myself speaking in front of people.
Yes, I believe that the media does have a big influence on the general public. People tend to believe what they read and see on television, so that does make a big impact on people today. American flag redefined the concept of freedom of expression in our country.
I personally think that the burning of the flag does not affect me because no one can burn my flag. I have so much respect for my United States and for the flag that there is no way that someone can take my flag from me and desecrate it.
What issues would you select as your platform?
I believe if I was elected as Miss America, my platform would be always present yourself as a lady.
Blouin. Becky, in your opinion, how should Miss America and Miss Mississippi handle controversial issues?
I think the way you should handle controversial issues is just really take a look on your inside and know that you're doing right, and if you know that, then you'll have no problem.
Lincoln County. Misty, tell me something your state excels in and an area which needs improvement.
I think that one of the areas that our state excels in is certainly our hospitality. I think that everyone that comes here talks about how hospitable we are and how much we welcome people to our state. I think that one area that we lack is in the education area. I think that if we can boost our economy, that we can truly build our education system.
Nicole Bethmann, Miss Gulf Coast. Nicole, in your opinion, who should be responsible for censoring TV programs for you?
I think that the government should set up a special cabinet or some type of committee to regulate what is shown on television today. Like I answered in my interview question before, there are too many negative temptations for youth today. And if something is not done soon and a joint effort is not made, our youth today are really going to be into some trouble. We need to affect their mind with positive aspects and not negative things.
Miss Morton. Shelley, as we approach the 21st century, how do you respond when one says pageants are outdated?
I don't think pageants are outdated. I think pageants are a very important part of many young ladies' lives. It helps us self-improve with self-improvement and self-confidence. And I know this week has definitely boosted my ego, and I feel that I am very confident and very blessed to be in this pageant.
Number 6, Angie Gilstrap, Miss Clinton. Angie, in your opinion, what is the greatest technological advance which has occurred in the 20th century?
I think it would have to be the computer. The computer has enabled us to reach into technology as never before.
Problem in this country, and how would you handle it?
I think the greatest problem in this country is the stress that young people are under today. Because of stress, so many of them get involved in drugs and alcohol, and I think part of this pageant and becoming a Miss Mississippi is to reach out to these young people and show them that someone cares, and as Miss Mississippi, I believe that I could do this effectively.
Thank you. and gentlemen, our top 10 finalists in evening gown competition. Competition is over, and we'll soon find out which young woman will be Miss Mississippi 1989. But right now, I'd like to take you back 1 year when a certain contestant performed a talent that was later to be seen on national television live from convention halls in Atlantic City. Here's the song and the contestant. Ladies and gentlemen, Miss Mississippi, Carla Hayes.
From now, my reputation goes on the line. Coming through. They're second to best. That's why these fish are from Jitney. All the beef at Jitney is USDA choice, trimmed just right, of course. And I can always count on tenderness.
Great steak, Frank.
It's especially for you.
You got it. Great steak at your neighborhood Jitney, where we do everything special especially for you.
The Miss Mississippi Pageant is now offering its annual program book for sale by mail. The 500-page book for 1989 includes a pictorial salute to the 40 contestants, plus former Miss Mississippi winners, Miss Americas from our state, and much, much more. Each program book is just $10 plus $2.95 each for shipping and handling. To order, send your name and address along with a check or money order to Miss Mississippi Pageant, P.O. Box 742, Vicksburg, Mississippi 39180, or phone 638-6746.
Thank you.
Peg will be leaving us with many exciting memories and much promise for the future. She's been a wonderful representative of our state. Ladies and gentlemen, Carla Hayes, it's Mississippi 1988.
Tonight marks the end of one of the most fabulous years of my life. A year which was filled with laughter, joy, travel, and getting to know the wonderful people of Mississippi. I have traveled from the East Coast to the West Coast and have visited Disneyland and the Kentucky Derby, but the greatest trips I have made are within my own state. The people of Mississippi have opened up their towns, their homes, and their hearts to me, and for your love, I will always be grateful. One of my fondest dreams was to one day wear the crown of Miss Mississippi. In fulfilling this wish, the joy of my reign has exceeded even my wildest expectations. Let me assure my successor that no matter how wonderful she dreams being Miss Mississippi will be, she can never imagine the honor and the happiness that the reality of wearing the crown will bring. The memories of this year will linger long after the crown is gone, and they have been made possible by all of you in Mississippi. To my family in Hattiesburg and to my adopted family in Vicksburg, let me say that without you, none of this would have been possible, and for that, I love you. I always thought there could be nothing greater than to be Miss America, but now I know there is one thing, and that's being Miss Mississippi.
Mississippi, we have several special awards. For the fourth time in our Mississippi history, we are awarding $800 scholarships to 8 non-finalist talent award winners. Now, these are the non-finalists who have achieved the highest scores in talent competition. They are Miss Jackson, Stacy Duke. Miss Golden Triangle, Dorothy Clapp. Miss Mississippi College, Belinda Austin. Miss Itawamba Community College, Amanda Pitt. Miss Grenada County, Amy Carlisle. Miss Northeast Community College, Lenena Holder. Miss Delta State University, Laura Williams. And Miss Hines Community College, Tracy Yarborough. Congratulations to all of these special women.
The Miss Mississippi Pageant Local Directors Association is proud to present a $500 scholarship to Miss Mississippi State University, Genevieve Fager. It's my privilege at this time to present the new Quality of Life Scholarship Award brought to us by Fruit of the Loom, major sponsor of the Miss America Pageant. The Fruit of the Loom Quality of Life Award will be presented to one winner.
We are experiencing temporary technical difficulties. Please stand by.
The Vicksburg JC Community Service Award of $500 is also presented to Miss Delta State University, Laura Williams.
The Miss Mississippi Pageant Board of Trustees Scholarship Award in the amount of $1,000 is being presented to Miss Pontotoc Angie Franklin. And the Miss Mississippi Broadcasters Award in the amount of $800 goes to Miss Grenada County, Amy Carlisle.
Ladies and gentlemen, on behalf of national sponsor Sheer Indulgent Hosiery, I'd like to announce that tonight's winner will receive a $1,000 scholarship. The Sheer Indulgent Confidence Scholarship will be awarded to each of the 51 state winners, recognizing that successful women like Miss Mississippi pursue their goals with confidence. This year's Miss Mississippi will also receive a total of $9,750 in additional cash scholarship awards. We salute the Vicksburg Port Commission for their support of the Miss Mississippi Scholarship Program and our $7,500 cash scholarship. And thank you to Showmax Originals, who have provided a $1,250 cash scholarship to Miss Mississippi. The auditors have totaled the judges' scores, and we are now ready to announce the names of our four alternates and the new Miss Mississippi. Ladies and gentlemen, the fourth alternate and winner of a $2,250 scholarship, Miss Morton Shelley Traxler. Third alternate, winner of a $2,900 scholarship, Dana Dalton, Miss Dixieland. Second alternate and winner of a $3,750 scholarship, Becky Blouin, Miss Dixie. Now, why don't you name the first runner-up and the young lady who will walk this ramp in a few seconds as the next Miss Mississippi?
I'd love to. The first alternate and winner of a $5,500 scholarship is Miss Magnolia, Missy Hurdle. Ladies and gentlemen, our new Miss Mississippi is Miss Tupelo, Sherry Busby.
Mississippi Pageant has been brought to you in part by Jitney Jungle, where we do everything special, especially for you.